How's it going, everyone? I'm Splatoon41, here with some more of Minecraft Wii U Edition. This time, I'm showing you a glitch. Two glitches, actually. So, let's get into the first glitch out of the two I want to show you. So, this will be done. I'm going to show this in my Let's Play world, because I think that's the best place to show this glitch. I don't think this was possible before this update, but whatever. Okay. So I need to go outside. I need to go outside the castle and I can show you this glitch. Literally, I was just messing around and all of a sudden I find this glitch. Look. Okay, here we go. I just need to be outside the castle. Right. So as you know, banners recently came out. On console edition, right? So I was standing around here, messing around with banners, you know, looking in the third person, but something interesting happened. You see? Okay. So yeah, here's third person. Okay, no, that's the wrong kind. Now watch. So I was messing around, taking pictures like this, but look! Look at that! You can X-ray. You can X-ray. You can just X-ray just like that. There. Right there. See? That's literally X-ray. And the way this seems to work is that as long as your little crosshair is pointed at a grass, you know, these little grass bits here, as long as your crosshair is pointed at one of those, no matter whether you're in third person or first person, either back or front third person, it will be X-ray basically. So you can see through the stone blocks. You can see all the caves and the openings and stuff. So yeah, this is definitely very helpful and very easy to pull off, so to speak. So yeah. Let's actually dig down. So basically, yeah, if you have grass blocks, And then you could just bone meal them. Okay, bone meal, grass blocks, and torches for light. So you could basically just dig down. Let's say you dig down. Oh wow, found a ravine. Is this one big? Okay, let's just dig down a little further. Okay, let's just dig down all the way to bedrock level, because why not? Okay. So, make a little place. You can make like a small little room here. Here's a potential use for this glitch. A way to make it easier to use. You can make a little room here at the bottom. Obviously, you wouldn't go this deep, because you need creative mode to break the bedrock. You wouldn't go this deep. You might go like a little further up. A little bit more useful there. So wherever you would want to go, you would just set up a room sort of like this. Obviously not as messy. And then you would put down some grass blocks. Okay. Like this. Make sure to remove the ceiling, because you want to have two blocks of space so you can stand there, right? I can't believe I just found this glitch, messing around. Okay, so yeah, and then you just bone meal the grass. And if you see any flowers or anything other than grass popping up, then just get rid of it, bone meal that again. Grass is the most fairly common of it. So yeah, then you just go third person and swing the camera under it. Boom! X-ray! It's that easy. It's literally that easy. Look at that. Look at that. And because I have night vision on, you can see everything. Like, look, there's some lapis up there. Let's see what else you can see. Oh wow, look at that mess up there. Yeah. Yeah, that's something. Okay. Maybe if I'm actually going to go over here a little bit and see what it'll do with just one. Yeah, okay. case. So just go like that, and third person. There you go. There you go. Just like that. As long as your crosshair is pointed at it, you will always be able to X-ray, and it's just ridiculous how much you are able to see. And look, I think you can see the castle all the way over to the left over there, just behind the caves. Wow, this is amazing to look at, isn't it? Alright, and so, yeah, that is definitely amazing. It's going to be very helpful. If you're planning to do this in pure survival with no host privileges, what you're probably going to need is a silk touch pickaxe and bone meal to be able to get grass blocks, because obviously when you mine grass blocks, you just get regular dirt. Yeah. So what you'll need is a silk touch pickaxe to be able to get grass blocks themselves. Okay, so the next glitch I'm going to show you is regarding a superflat. Here we go. So if you go like here, so delete that, and what you want to do is go to the end, right? You can leave all this stuff on or off, it doesn't really matter, I don't think. But you want to turn decorations on and biome specifics on, because I'm not sure which one it is. I'm not sure whether it's biome specifics or decorations that does this, but I'm just going to leave both on just to be sure. So basically now what you want to do is make this go all the way up to build height. No wait, go all the way up to the maximum limit, to the maximum height limit, and have it be a block that is not one of the end blocks. Or obsidian. So then you go. So I'm going to go with sand. Yeah, okay. Then make sure I have that turned on so I can switch into creative. And there you go. Now you just wait for it to load and you'll see. You'll see the glitch. You'll see it. So, there it is. You see it already. Look at that. And that's not a graphical error. No. That's not a graphical error. This obsidian, there's no obsidian here. So this is what happens when you do it at the height limit. It causes the crystals to generate out of place. See, look at this. Here they are. You can't stand on them. They have no hitbox. Or even if... I have no idea whether... Is that in Survival 2? Sure. Let's see. Oh, this is gonna kill me. Yep. So look at that. The end crystals. The ender crystals, or whatever they're called, are just floating there. Just like that. Just floating right there. See? And, yeah, obviously if you hit them, they blow up just as normal, right? They still power the Ender Dragon just as normal too, still hurt it when you hit them while it's charging it, yeah. I'll tell you one thing though, if you fight the Ender Dragon like this, he'll make hitting them way more easier. Yeah. But let me just try that out. Armor on in case they hit me, the Enderman on me, and golden apples, protection, and sword. Okay, I'm going to show you how easy it is to hit them now. Yep. There you go, that one's gone. I left two. Boom, that one's gone too. Goodbye, end crystals. floating ones. They're all gone now. Yeah. By the way, these go all the way down to bedrock, I'm pretty sure. Oh man, I want speed boost, please. Okay, here we go. It's going to take a little while to dig down, isn't it? Even in creative mode. We're digging, digging, digging. Just keeping on digging. We're digging, all day. We're digging. Okay. Yeah. Oh, look at that. Look at that. See? Here's another glitch. I had a feeling that this would happen, but I just hadn't checked it till now. It in fact does happen. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take one of these, see if this works. Okay, first of all, I want this. Okay, good. Now let's try this. Glitches in one. I wasn't expecting this one. I just got curious while recording this now. Yep, that's definitely the bedrock layer right there. And just for fun, it's the entire build limit. Look at that. Look at that go. This is fun. Them falling ever so slowly now. Yeah, that's going to take a while. But yeah! Oh man, you just find so many glitches in this game. And you know what? Just because I feel like it, I'm going to do this. I'm going to do the first glitch right now. I mean, I'm not going to find anything because I didn't turn caves on. But yeah. By the way, this is the grass color in the end, in case you didn't know. Weird, isn't it? Oh yeah, there you go. So yeah, that's pretty much all the glitches I have to show you. So yeah. I guess that about wraps up this video, so thanks for watching, be sure to leave a like because I also wear a channel, and be sure to subscribe for some more of Minecraft Wii U Edition. Alright, thanks for watching, bye!